Hey guys, Triple T Cat here, and today I'm taking a look at Battlefield 4. This is basically going to be my review of the game, although I'm not really following a formal review structure. I'm just going to talk about what I think of the game now that, you know, it's out. It's been out for a little while, it's got some patches and stuff like that. So, where are we at? Before we get into it, I'll just remind you guys that I really didn't like the beta. If you watch my beta video, you'll remember that. If you didn't, I'll tell you now. And I had a lot of complaints about Battlefield 3, ultimately, despite also enjoying a lot of aspects of the game. I felt like it left a lot to be desired, and I felt the same way about the beta of this game and the original release date of this game to a certain extent as well. But how does it stack up now? Let us find out. Obviously it looks amazing. That's not really that important, but it does help. The art style is a big improvement from Battlefield 3's Hyper Blue Ultra Depression. I really wasn't a fan of that. This is a lot better. Single player is garbage. If you thought BF3's campaign sucked, you have no idea. I mean, compared to BF4's, BF3's single player campaign was like the greatest thing ever. They tried to make it feel like more open or something, and there are a couple of alright levels because of that, but overall, it had like a nonsensical story, and the gameplay just wasn't fun at all. The campaign was a complete failure. I don't know why they even bothered to include that. Like, I think they should go back to just including bots, like they did in the old days, but fuck it. But neither of those things is that important. Nobody buys Battlefield for the single player. You'd have to be some kind of moron to do that, so let's move on to the stuff that actually matters. Overall, it's pretty much the same game as Battlefield 3, so if you really didn't like Battlefield 3 at all, or got so critically bored of it that the idea of playing a game that's very similar sounds absolutely awful to you, you can stop watching right now and skip BF4 knowing that you aren't really missing out on much that would have been interesting to you. If that's not you, though, and you still think the series has some life after BF3, then there is some good news, and that's that the game has been improved in quite a lot of ways. Most of them fairly small, but also in some bigger ways. I don't even probably have time to mention all of them. For example, I wasn't initially going to talk about the interface, but I'll just mention briefly the interface is a lot better in many respects. But as a result of all these improvements, the game is overall, I think, a considerably better experience than BF3. The beta and original release both felt awful in terms of performance, this is a weird stuttering issue, in terms of stability, because there were a shitload of crashes, the netcode was even worse than BF3's, which is impressively bad. But those issues have actually been mostly resolved, and in fairly short order by DICE, which really, really surprised me, to be honest. I didn't think DICE would fix most of that crap, at least not for a long time, but I haven't had any crashes in a while. The stuttering issue is gone, was gone even before I upgraded my PC. And the netcode still isn't great, but it now mostly feels better than BF3 did. You know, there's a little bit less getting shot around corners, a little bit less of that sort of weird delay feeling. It's strange it took DICE so long to acknowledge that there was a problem, since the netcode was garbage for all of BF3's lifespan. But they actually have done a little to improve it now, and they seem to plan to work on it more, which, as I said, is pretty surprising, but, you know, that's good. It's good. Aside from that, other improvements, like, I feel like the weapons and classes are generally a bit better balanced. That there are a few guns I think are kind of OP, but mostly I think it's a bit better in that respect. And I think there's been a massive, massive improvement in terms of how vehicles are balanced against infantry. It's much less a case of maps being these terrible clusterfucks being blown up by OP vehicles 24/7 than in Battlefield 3, where I kind of felt like that happened a lot. And it makes the game a lot more enjoyable, especially for infantry players, and I always felt like infantry was the most fun aspect of the game, so that's nice. Vehicles are still strong enough to be an asset to a team, and they're still fun to use, but they're a lot harder to really dominate in, except maybe for scout helicopters. I think those need some tweaking, but mostly that's nice. The map design is also a lot better than BF3. You see me here on Siege of Shanghai, which is unfortunate. This is just the first game I grabbed today. This is probably one of the worst design maps in the game. Maybe not the very worst, but generally speaking, the map design's a lot better. Even the game's equivalent of Operation Metro, which is called Operation Locker, isn't that bad of a map. And the more expansive open maps feel like a lot less of a chore, because there's generally more transport vehicles around, and because constantly being blown up 24/7 by jets and attack helicopters is less of an issue. Like, Operation Paracel Storm is a really good map to play. It's a really fun map. I really like Golmud Railway, too. There's some really good maps in this game, unlike BF3, where there were, like, okay maps. But none of the maps in BF3 really spoke to me as being great maps. They were just kind of okay at best. Also, like, naval combat. Naval combat is pretty fun, and I'm glad to see it coming back into the game as something meaningful, although it's too bad they didn't take it as far as earlier games in the franchise, which allowed you to control larger ships like carriers and destroyers. That's not back, but at least, you know, there's a little bit more expansion in naval combat. There's a bunch of other smaller refinements and improvements too. Reviving fuel is less cheap than in BF3. Counter-knifing's a fun feature. The ability to peek around cover is neat, and naturally feels pretty natural once you get used to it. There's a better variety of grenades and secondary weapons and full secondary weapon customization. Overall, the game feels a little bit more tactical than BF3 on most maps, and actually feels a little closer to old Battlefield games to me than BF3 did. Which is nice. It's kind of sad to see a bunch of the features that they added back in from old Battlefield games coming off as half-cocked, though, like the naval combat. And Commander Mode is another example, which DICE wants you to think is a huge deal, but I find Commander Mode really boring to play, and when I'm playing the game normally as an infantry, just as a soldier for infantry in a vehicle, I barely notice a difference whether there's a commander for my team or not. Having one gives you a bit of an advantage, sure, but it's not really a big deal. So that's another feature that I feel like was kind of undercooked. They put it in because players demanded it, but it didn't really... Not that great! The other thing that DICE wanted you to think was going to be a really big deal that is kind of a nice feature, but not... I don't even want to say it. I don't know how the guys at DICE can say it with a straight face. The other... supposedly big feature is, Levolution. This gimmick is a fun feature and kind of cool, I guess, but not a big game changer. I like its presence, but it's not some kind of huge hyper-advanced selling point like they wanted you to think it is. It's just kind of neat, I guess. On some of the maps, it's cooler than others. It's nice, but it's not that big of a deal. There's more stuff I could talk about, but I think you get a pretty good idea of how I generally feel about the game, so I'm going to wrap this up. So my final verdict on BF4 is that if you liked BF3 a lot and want more of the same, there's no reason not to buy Battlefield 4. My initial negativity towards the game has mostly gone as a result of DICE actually taking some steps to fix the things that made the game unplayable, which has allowed the things about the game that are actually pretty good to shine through. Is it an amazing game? No, of course not. But there's nothing really wrong about it. Just if you just want like a casual military shooter for a mass audience, it does that reasonably well. It can be pretty fun at times. So those are my thoughts on Battlefield 4. You can expect to see more videos of the game coming in the near future, since as it turns out, I don't hate it as much as I thought I would. And thanks for watching. And until then. Triple T Cat out.